Welcome back to the Island 54 Devlog. Today I'll continue my quest to make my MMO server massively scalable. Last week, I covered the theory of microservice architecture in detail and got a start on developing the first of the services. This week, I finished building out the services, but this refactor has unfortunately turned into a three-parter, with deployment and Unity integration falling out to next week. I'll be walking through how I tested the session manager from last week, how the UDP receiver service works, the other services I developed this week, and what work is still outstanding. Again, there's no real demo this week, since it was all back-end changes. But I hope to be able to get back to showing off visual changes again soon. I do recommend you watch last week's episode before this one if you want to understand why I'm building things the way I am. One last thing before I get started. I promised I'd create a Discord server once we got to 1,000 subscribers, and we hit it just after last week's episode dropped. I want to thank everyone for their support and invite you to join me over on the new Discord server, where you can discuss the latest changes I'm making, get more frequent updates, and make suggestions for what I can do better. There's an invite link in the description below. I left off last week's episode having developed a basic session manager service. I'm not that experienced with Node or Express, and something felt a bit off. My controllers felt too tightly coupled with Express, which seemed kind of weird. So I looked up some best practice for structuring these services and adjusted my service to match. I then went and wrote some tests. There's basically at least one unit test per route and per controller method. I'll just walk you through the testing for one of the administrative endpoints for now, the one that fetches all sessions. There are two tests on the route layer. I mock the session controller to return either no results or a valid result and check that the correct response body is received through the API endpoint. I then similarly tested the controller layer by mocking out Redis. By setting up the Redis mock to return either 0 or 1 session, we expect the controller layer to deserialize those sessions and pass them back to the caller. While it looks sort of repetitive, keeping the unit tests this focused helps keep them really simple and gets pretty close to guaranteeing that the system as a whole will work as intended. Rather than writing automated integration tests, I just manually tested it by starting up a Redis server in Docker and testing my service against it. I checked the admin fetch all endpoint, then posted a couple of new sessions, then hit the fetch all endpoint again. It was all looking pretty good. I next implemented the UDP receiver service. I knew I was going to be changing a lot about the UDP side of things. So rather than basing it off the old UDP code, I copied my session management service as a starting point. I kept Express in there so I could integrate more easily with management systems and wrote a directory endpoint that lets clients know where to go for various parts of the system. This allows a client to be configured by just supplying the URL of the directory service. Everything else can then be discovered automatically. I rewrote my UDP listener to take a datagram receiver as a parameter. The listener just creates the socket, configures some error handlers and things, then binds the socket to the port specified in the config. The datagram receiver is where all the heavy lifting goes. Whenever a datagram is received, it pulls out the control word, the session ID, and the hash, followed by the actual payload. The control word has a special debug bit in it for now, letting me disable encryption while I'm testing. The code then requests the session from the service manager and verifies the hash. It also checks that if the remote endpoint has previously been recorded, that it matches. Otherwise, it sets it on the session to be recorded by the session manager later. This is still susceptible to a UDP amplification attack. I have a solution in mind already, but let me know down below if you can see how this current protocol could be compromised and how you would go about fixing it. I wrote a protobuf specification that is able to parse vector threes, my hexagonal coordinates, and basic transforms. It then has the concept of entity and component updates. Either side of the connection can bundle up a number of component value changes or deletions into a datagram to be sent to the other side. Back to the UDP receiver, it parses the payload against the protobuf spec and passes any updates off to the entity service. Lastly, it notifies the session manager that we have a verified sighting of this session, so the session can be kept alive. I wrote a command line client that lets me construct datagrams from the command line, since I don't have a working Unity client yet. The client prints out the bytes it transmits too, making it easier to write unit tests. The entity service is trivial at this point. All it has is endpoints to accept updates from clients and enumerate all the entities it is currently tracking. The entities get stored as separate documents in MongoDB, which is again running in a Docker container. The UDP transmitter service is based pretty heavily on the old code. I was intending to have it call into the session services tick manager to control its timing and work distribution, but ran out of time. So for now, it remains non-scalable. Each instance just sends packets out to every session every 100 milliseconds. I'm not going to go into a huge amount of detail on these services to avoid too much repetition, and because I'm sure I'll cover them in more detail in upcoming episodes. So what's left for me to do? I need to improve the UDP transmitter service to allow multiple instances to share the workload. I also need to handle sessions going away. When a session goes away, we probably want to remove the character's entity from the world. So that still needs to happen. I still need to write the chunk generation service. It's not so important for the terrain side of things until players can control the terrain more, but it is needed to allow the system to store changes to entities that get created at terrain generation time. I also need to write the deployment code. I test the system locally by running multiple Redis instances, a Mongo instance, and four node processes. That's a pain. So I'll write a Docker Compose spec that runs all those various bits for me. I then want to deploy a cluster out to AWS. And most importantly, I need to integrate these changes with my Unity code. Unity will need to talk to these new services. I'll need to strip out a lot of the generation code and rely more heavily on the data coming back from the server. But I'm now out of time for this week's episode. So that's all going to have to wait until next week. If you're enjoying the series, don't forget to leave a thumbs up and subscribe. Remember to watch last week's episode for a deeper dive into why I'm building my server as microservices. If you're new here, you might want to binge the entire series to date. But until next time, happy game developing.